More of your silly designs, Katya?
Give it back, Mom.
Of course. But why don't you read something instead? Or watch television? You're supposed to keep your mind active, not obsessed. You just keep doing the same design over and over again. It's not right. You mustn't go on this way, Katya. One day soon, you're going to get up out of bed. And you'll be fine. And all of this will be an unpleasant memory.
Carl Blitz, and make him stop barking. God, that dog's annoying.
How's the pressure?
Dropping.
Give him some oxygen. Number two. Number three, Emily. Number one. Four. Pressure?
Normal.
Check the heartbeat. One. Four.
Doctor.
1.5 cc's.
Hey, look who's there!
Hey, Grandpa, how you doing?
Shaughnessy. Shaughnessy.
Is that you, Sergeant?
You better watch your step, Shaughnessy. If I catch you drunk just once more, I'm gonna have to lock you up. Get it?
I'm not drunk. I'm not drunk.
You understand what I'm telling you?
Sergeant, they got a badly wounded man in the hospital. They want to talk to you.
Okay, this is Engelman. Yeah, I'll be right over. Watch it.
He isn't going to make it. Adrenaline. That's enough. Pressure and cardiac rhythm?
Normal.
Thank you. Sutures.
It's absurd. Completely absurd. Recuperative powers like that simply don't exist.
A tribute to you.
Skill, Doctor.
I'd like to accept the compliment, Emily, but I can't. You were there, and you saw what happened. He started recovering on his own before I even had a chance to begin the heart massage.
Yes, I saw, but what I remember are his eyes. For a minute, I thought he was really conscious.
A nervous contraction. Or at least, let's say, that's the only explanation I can come up with. What I'm remembering is how quickly his blood coagulated while I was operating on him. Something I've never seen before in my life.
Could it be an anomaly of the lymphatic system?
It's possible. We'll do all the indicated tests and analyses, of course. Could you take care of that, please, Emily?
Oh, I'm supposed to go to the Bennett's place. Is that all right?
Ah, yes, yes. How is the little girl?
She has tremendous willpower. I hope to God that deviation will disappear.
It will. And thanks will be due to you, as well as to him. Go on.
Thank you, Doctor. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
It was a horrible thing. The first thing I did when I came to my senses was to phone the hospital. But I suppose there's not much hope for the poor man.
No, I'm afraid not. I'm no doctor. But I don't think it looks good. They don't expect him to pull through. I saw the blood on the gate. You know what I'm wondering? How did he manage to wound himself in that way? Had you ever seen this man before?
No, never. I imagined that he was going to rob the house.
What, bull a robbery with the owners at home? Doesn't make sense. Your husband is away?
No, he's out on a job. Decided to watch the game on television at the Forest. They're friends of ours. They live nearby. They're expecting us at 10. We don't like to leave Katya on her own too long.
Of course. How's she coming along?
Oh, better. But there's still a long time to go before she can get out of bed.
I see. Well, I'll be getting on my way. Goodbye, Mrs. Bennett, and
all right.
Thank you for your help. Give my regards to Katya.
Right? I will, thanks.
Sir, could I see some identification, please? Driver's license, credit card.
Ah, yes. Yes, I've got... I have a passport.
Thank you, sir. What are you doing in this neck of the woods? Visiting our roaring metropolis on foot?
Oh, no, my automobile. It breaks down. some kilometers.
Kilometers, huh? Well, it's lucky you bumped into me. There's no one out tonight. They've all gone home to watch the game. It's a big night. The Rams and the Steelers for the championship. Get in. I'll see if I can find you a mechanic.
Oh, it's very kind. Thank you.
You like football? American football, that is. Oh, yes. Yes. That's it, huh?
That's all of it, Ben.
No identification.
No smoking. Leaving so soon?
I have to run home before I go out to the Bennetts. See you tomorrow. Bye, Sergeant.
See ya.
So long. She's a great girl. Wasted in a place like this.
Strange. Greek. Drachmas. That other fellow's a Greek, too.
What fellow?
Oh, nothing. When can I see the patient? Soon?
Not till tomorrow. Doctor's orders.
Okay. But you've seen him. What's he look like?
He's huge. Not my type at all. He has a strange face. The kind you'd rather not meet at night when you're alone.
Oh, come on. When is a nice-looking girl like you ever alone? And especially at night.
You're kidding, Ben. This town's a graveyard. I wish you'd run after me. At least you're a bachelor.
Well, that can easily be arranged. Just murder someone, and I will.
See you around, Ben.
Bye, Thelma.
How is he doing?
Incredibly well. Look at him. Only 2 hours ago, he was on the operating table.
So I see. It is incredible. Like the histological examinations and all the other tests. They indicate his blood is reproducing itself at triple the normal rate.
Did you tell Dr. Kramer?
Yeah. He said to send everything to the biophysical lab for further tests.
Doctor!
He's awake. About.
Hello, Walter. It's Ben. Oh, you're asleep. Sorry. No, look. I left a guy in front of your house about half an hour ago. Said his car broke down. That's right. A foreigner.
Huh? Nobody, huh? Okay. Okay. Sorry about that, huh? Go back to sleep.
Greek.
Hey, Sergeant. Sergeant, Peter's bar didn't close until after hours, as usual. He doesn't give a damn about the law. I think we should pull him in this time.
Yeah. All right, Thelma. Huh? What? I'll be right over there. Hold on.
Where are we off to, Sarge?
We're gonna have a few words with a lying tourist.
Everything seems to be all right again. But I still think you better have 2 units of Pedimix.
Yes, Doctor.
Dr. Gruber, you're needed in the emergency ward. Dr. Gruber, please.
Yes, what is it?
A young boy has damaged his hand with a firecracker.
I'll be right there. Thelma, don't leave him alone, not for a minute. Mm-hmm. It's all yours, Sergeant.
Thank you, Jim. Well, so you decided to come to the hospital to get your car fixed. Is that it? To Mister. Huh? That guy in there is afraid of you. Why? Are you responsible for the wounds he's got? Huh? Fuck, damn you! Decided to talk? Sit down.
But it is important that I go with you. Important.
Stay just where you are. Keep an eye on him, Jim. Once more from the top. You entered this country 2 days ago, not right?
I have already told you my story, Inspector. There is no more time that we can lose.
Well, mister, I'm just a dumb small-town cop, and I have trouble understanding certain things, especially if they're so crazy. So far up. Lots of us hicks are like that. So, let's hear it again.
I know how it seems, my story, but there exists a reality that we do not see.
Is that a fact? It's really kind of you to tell me that. Well, it's the reality I did see that interests me. That nurse back there. The one with the drill through her head.
Yes. Yes, I know. And it is sad for me. Well, I will tell everything. But I should like the doctor who operated on him that he should also be present. He will convince you better than I.
Okay. Let's go see Dr. Kramer.
It's extraordinary. I've never seen such an extensive cerebral mass. This one, we took after the operation.
It doesn't make sense, Dr. Kramer. His brain got bigger after the operation.
I know. Science cannot accept it.
So this Nikos Thanopoulos is, how shall I put it, immortal?
Nor can blind faith accept it, but it is so. His body can regenerate dead cells.
Now that is hard to believe.
It'll be from you. Engelman. Yeah, I was expecting the call. Put him through. Yeah, this is Engelman. All right, thanks. So, it turns out you're a priest.
I serve God with biochemistry more than with rites and ceremonies.
Yes, the consul told me you're doing some kind of experimental work in your institute. But shouldn't you have alerted the authorities instead of running after this guy on your own?
When he escaped from the laboratory, after the contamination, we advise authorities. They organize great hunt. You see this? Here is written that he is dead. Officially dead.
Well, we didn't use the picture, but what's the article about?
Excuse me, it is written that Mikos is killed by rifles, by expert marksmen, and that his body is disappeared into the sea.
All right. Let's get back to now. Tell me, we know he kills, only do you know why?
I would say that he does not regenerate cells perfectly, that he is insane.
We have to find some way of stopping him.
But you just said he can't be killed.
Oh, but there is a way. His blood coagulates and his cell memory reconstitutes any organ that is injured, all but his brain. Once the cerebral cells are destroyed, they cannot regenerate. It is his brain that is his weak point.
don't need them tomorrow morning. I need them now, damn it. I can't get you the captain's order. He's at home watching the game. It's my ass if I call him now. Damn them and damn you. Nothing doing. They can't send anyone till tomorrow morning. And in the meantime, that thing is walking our streets.
Tomorrow morning could be too late. We must be the ones to move.
So this is the team, eh? A priest, a detective near retirement, and a young moron rookie of a cop. Terrific. Just terrific.
It is better that I have a gun. I know what you are thinking, but there is nothing of human left in him. He is creature of evil. The spark of God was smothered the moment the devil took possession of him.
I guess you know more about that line of business than I do, Father. I'll give you a car, and we can look for him separately. It's not a big town, but it's spread out.
Remember, you must hit at his brain. Nothing else will help us.
Thank you.
If you're thinking of what went on, yes, I can forgive that. Only, how does one forgive the future?
Oh, hi, Daddy.
Well, let it come in order to see what...
Hi, Monster.
I know you left...
A real monster came today.
Stop that, Willie. We had an accident.
What kind of accident?
A thief tried to climb over the gate and was wounded horribly on the points. They took him to the hospital.
Even the police were here, Daddy.
Sergeant Engelman dropped by. It seems the man was a foreigner. But he'll come by tomorrow and let us know more.
Okay. Aren't you ready yet?
Leaving the kids on their own, especially after what happened today. I thought we could stay home and watch the game and be alone.
Oh, come on, Carol. Forrester expecting us. We can't just not show. We should have warned them earlier. Did you ask Emily if she can sleep over?
I did phone her. She said she would, but she isn't here yet.
She'll get here. You get ready. I'll go see Katya.
All right. All right.
It's not too late, Angela, darling. We could start again. Why not?
How can you ever think that now?
It's easy. When your feelings run as deep as mine do, my dearest, nothing seems to be impossible.
It can't be. No, you know that.
That's simply not true, my love. We did decide on a policy of forgive and forget, didn't we?
You did, no. I can't. If you're thinking of what went on, yes, I can forgive that. Only, how does one forgive the future?
One doesn't think about the future, my love. One lets it come in order to see what it may bring. I know you love me and you know it too.
Hey, put that back on.
Hey, Alice.
Give me that.
Willie, quit that.
Hi, Princess. How are you doing?
Fine. Did Mama tell you about what happened?
She did. Were you frightened?
No. But Willie cried for a solid hour.
Your mother and I are going over to the forests. Do you mind?
No, Daddy. What happened? What's the matter?
Why?
You're strange. You seem worried. It makes me think something's the matter. If it's about me, please don't worry. I'm fine. Honestly, I am. Really.
I'm glad to hear that. Anyway, if I'm nervous, it's something to do with work. Nothing serious. Okay?
Okay.
Sarge, is it true the only way to kill him is by shooting him through the head?
That's right, Sherlock. Now, all you gotta do is keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. You got it?
Bye, dear. Peggy, remember, you're not to leave until Emily gets here. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Whose car shall we take?
Well, let's take mine. It's in front. I just hope that little moron does as I told her. I'm feeling very nervous.
Oh, stop worrying. We're just going down the road. After all, it's not as if we were leaving for South America.
Yes, but why is Emily so late?
Drop this when you fell down back there.
Thank you.
Oh, hi. You got here just in time.
Oh, hey.
Glad you're coming.
How are you?
It's fine. How are you?
Hey.
Oh, hi.
I
guess we better get everything ready.
I'll help you.
I think I like the rest.
A little less than a minute left until kickoff time, folks.
Do it soon.
Rams won the toss
and have
elected to receive.
What?
The Steelers have chosen to
defend
the East
goal to
take advantage of favorable wind when they change.
Sorry, John, I'm not feeling all that great.
There's been a lot of excitement.
Just what old Doc Forrest described here.
Yeah, this is what Harry and Chester.
Pittsburgh is more or less putting it on the line with Los Angeles. A team that got off to a slow start this year and then surprised everyone by moving up to a tie with the league leaders in their division at the end of the season, mainly through the throwing arm of their rookie sensation quarterback, Josh McDougal.
Willie, please. Quit that sniffling or the boogeyman will be getting you.
It's not true. Mommy says there is no boogeyman.
Oh, no? And who do you think that was we saw before? And you can't be sure he won't come back. You'd better get into that bed and hide your face under the covers. Because if you can't see him, he can't see you.
What will he do if he does see me?
He'll eat you. You know what it feels like to be eaten.
Peggy, I'm thirsty. A glass of water, please. Willie, don't listen to her. There's no such thing as a boogeyman.
Well, what about that guy we saw before?
He was just a poor old man. He was hurt. But Peggy's right about one thing, though. It is your bedtime. Now get undressed. Blitz. What is it? What's worrying you? Peggy, how are the children? Has Emily shown up yet?
No, not yet, Ma. I just put him to bed.
Well, do wait till Emily's there, would you please?
Oh, yes, of course I will. Bye.
All right. Thank you. Bye.
Maybe it was a car accident. I suppose whoever it was could have been taken off to the hospital.
Yeah? Car accident, huh? Not a scratch on the bike.
Oh, Jesus.
See Katya now, Here we are. We'll be
about to for the rounds at their own 45-yard line. Play's been called. We're at the line of scrimmage. McDougal's wrapping out his call.
Oh, thank you.
And McDougal hands the ball up the line with speedy sideways back coming around from the weak side. He's looking for running room. He's got some. He's across the midfield stripe. Sidesteps a tackle. He's heading for the sidelines. And he's finally brought down by big Larry Pack, number 31. That's called
John, could you give this place to Eon, please?
Here,
let's
keep an answer to that.
Okay, it's first down again. You're on the line. It's a quick snap. A big move pass over left guard. Brooks intercept for the Wolves. Not wasting any time. They're in their huddle already. They're up to the line of scrimmage for their first play. And it's Bradshaw going back to the pocket looking for a receiver. And he sees big number 32 and nails him. And there goes Mr. Harris. He's gone 15, 20, 23. And he's finally stopped by Youngblood, number 27 of the Ramblin' for a gain of 23 yards.
Well, I wish I were in Italy. Where are you? Every time I eat.
Friendliest station in the state. Now back to this evening's exciting contest between Los Angeles Rams.
As far as I'm concerned, you're hired. Don't make me laugh, Carol. You can put circles around me all day in the month, and you know.
Sure.
Padre, this is Engelman. Can you hear me? Pick up the microphone in front of you and push the button to talk.
Yes, Inspector, I hear you.
There's a new victim, a boy from the North End. I called the hospital. They're sending out an ambulance to pick him up. He was torn to shreds. You were right, Padre. That's no man. It's a monster.
You're really nasty. I'm not going to love you anymore if you go on with your stupid jokes.
I didn't mean to scare you like that, Emily.
I know, Willie, I know. I'm not mad, honestly. Don't think about it anymore. And Katya, you mustn't be too mad at Willie either. I'm sure he won't try it again. I know what. While I'm busy with Katya, why don't you go into the den and watch the football game on television, okay?
Okay.
Oh, by the way, what happened to Peggy? Wasn't she supposed to wait for me?
The boogeyman ate her.
I asked her for a glass of water and she disappeared. Probably she was angry. I'm sure she isn't.
Liz has disappeared too, Emily.
I'm sure he's sniffing around the house somewhere. Let's go switch on that television set. Come on. Sit down, Tiger.
Just 3 minutes left to play in the
first half. Now, you stay here and behave yourself, okay?
Okay.
Los Angeles, too. Harris was caught napping in his own end zone by Youngblood. It's certainly been his nemesis today.
Hello.
Emily, is that you?
Yes, Dr. Kramer. How are you?
There's something I have to tell you.
Okay, I'm all ears.
It's about Thelma Gardelli up at the hospital. I'm afraid she was brutally murdered by that man we were operating on this morning.
Oh, my God. How horrible.
I know how close the two of you were, so I thought I'd better tell you right away.
Did they get him?
No, he disappeared without a trace. Well, he did leave one trace. He murdered a boy on a street in the north section of town. The police are out looking for him now, but I understand they're hampered by a lack of available manpower. He's a bloodthirsty beast. Unfortunately, he has such a rapid coefficient of blood coagulation that he can block up any wound he receives in just a few seconds before he can die.
That just can't be. You've got to be joking, Doctor.
I wish I were, but I assure you I'm not. I witnessed it in person. It seems the only way to kill him is to hit him in the cerebral mass.
How is that possible?
Don't ask me. I'm more perplexed than you are. Well, I felt I had to tell you.
Yes. Thank you. Oh, by the way, didn't you say the body of that child was found in the North Quarter?
Yes, Emily, which is where you are now. I think you'd better sleep there at the Bennett's tonight. Don't try to go home.
Yes, I see. Thank you.
Down to the line of scrimmage. The receivers break, and it's a quarterback sneak. And there he goes. He's across the 45 at an incredible lateral pass almost the width of the field into Martinson's waiting arms. And I don't think anyone is going to stop him. He's a past midfield. The 40, the 35, he's over the 20-yard line now. And Martinson's over for the first touchdown of the game right at halftime.
How long ago did Peggy leave?
Oh,
About 10 minutes before you got here. And your parents are over at the Forrest's place?
Yes. Why do you ask?
Oh, no, no reason.
How much longer do we have to do this?
Until you can get up. It's the only way to keep your muscles in action. Otherwise, when the day comes that you're finally cured, you won't be able to stand on your feet.
But are you sure I'll be cured?
Of course, sweetheart. You're under a type of traction now that will eliminate that deviation in the spinal column. You're sure to get better. You're young.
A handoff to Mortensen, who sweeps around his own left end, cuts back inside, avoids a tackle, and looks around for some blocking, and he's galloping. Big number 72 just gave him a beautiful block, and he's got more room. He's past midfield, he's past before anyone. Come heck or high water, as my old pappy used to say. Power and speed and lots of smart. Very well go all the way. Just sit back and watch.
Hey, I'm telling you,
the Pittsburgh Steelers are your common garden variety junior high school team either. They've got one of the greatest defensive lines in history, and the opposing team.
Unbelievable.
I'm wondering where the points went to. Couple that with a gentleman named Mr. Terry Bradshaw, and you've got a mixture that's sometimes almost too rich for human consumption.
All right,
here come the Rams. First and 10 on the Pittsburgh 29.
Of course, made her look 30 pounds heavier.
And a pass it is. Peterson's going up. Peterson's going up, and he snags it down in the end zone, and it's 53 Rams.
There's no telling him or honest to me.
Watch how the camera stays on Big Johnny Horvath, the Pittsburgh number 58. He's mean and he's tough and he is out of luck, believe you me. And he makes the tackle. What a seesaw, ding-dong, back and forth, whip-flicking Donnybrook we've got going here today, folks. We're in the fourth quarter.
Blitz.
Just under 3 minutes to go. The Steelers are down 15-3, but they look beat. Have they given up? There is just one answer to that, folks. It's a two-letter word that starts with N and ends with O. Try it in your next crossword puzzle.
Nonsense.
Honestly.
I hope you're not just trying to scare us again.
It's the truth. Honest. He wanted to eat me. Come see. Come see.
All right, I'll go have a look. But you stay here. I already told you, there is no boogeyman out there. Now, would you calm down and stop trying to scare people?
get together next Wednesday for lunch. And for God's sake, don't bring Jill, okay? Bye. Carol, it's all yours. As far as I can tell, there's no one here.
I imagine they're all sleeping. What's the matter with you, Ian?
Nothing. Other than running over a man today and not stopping to help him.
Oh, Ian.
Emily, what happened?
Oh, nothing at all. The lights simply went out. I'll turn them back on. Now, don't you move. Understand?
All right.
I sent him away to look for help. We just got to stay here until someone comes. Do you understand? You mustn't be frightened. Oh. Oh.
Do such a thing. Do you know what they could do to you now?
I don't know what happened to me. I just didn't stop, that's all. I was tired. I was in a hurry to get home to you and the kids.
But whoever it was might be lying in a ditch, hurt.
No, I'm positive. I just brushed against him.
Oh, Ian. Look. They've turned the lights on again. I guess they're not asleep.
Thank you. Yeah!
someone's coming, Carol.
Where is he?
What's happened?
Mommy! Daddy! Here I am! Here I am!
Oh, darling, are you all right?
Oh, sure.
Listen, Willie, is he still in the house?
I don't know.
Is who still in the house? Who?
What's going on?
The boogeyman.
What is it? Look, Willie, you don't need to be afraid anymore.